So, you know, I enjoy being matchmaker. I really do. And I love wrestling with a passion. And when we have these guys coming around, it's like... As I was saying, the commentary job, Mark, sometimes isn't fun, only because of people like this one here and Buddy Ryder.
Watch out! Let me say one thing right now. This young Jeff Jarrett has come to the world-class area and done quite well for himself. But there's one thing. He suffers from a common American disease called nose trouble. He's beginning to stick his nose into my business, and I can tell you right now, Jeff Jarrett, you'll pay the consequences when you fool around with a general.
That guy said more than you and I have tonight.
Between him and Buddy Rollins, Mark, I feel like I'm backing up to the pay line tonight.
Beast on Jarrett in the corner with a choke.
Beast doing what he needs to do here, and that's use his ties against Jeff Jarrett. Jeff Jarrett doing just what he has to do. Ho-ho! Using his speed and quickness, and that's what a beast. He's an animal at heart, Mark. And you've got it. He's doing, Jarrett's doing just exactly what he's got to do. And that's rattling. And just like he's got a bad guard or anything else, you've got to confuse him. And that's what Jarrett's trying to do. Confuse him with speed. Confuse him with a little razzle-dazzle.
And the one thing that hurts Skandor Akbar, the one thing that really gets to him, is being embarrassed or having one of his men embarrassed.
Well, certainly, you can't find him to take his money. Geez, he just won't dig another oil well, and here we go again. So there's only thing I can do, the only thing any wrestler can do, not me, any wrestler can do, is to embarrass good old Skandor Akbar.
The Beast continuing on Jerry now and getting rough over along the road.
Well, what kind of idle threat is this? Every time I turn around, the guy's making such a... I'll tell you, he makes matchmaking very difficult. Botswana Beast, this is one of the toughest tests that Jeff Jarrett has had. He's by himself out here against this 350-plus pounder. Akbar schooled him well. Take away, you're choking him now, trying to take away the speed of Jeff Jarrett. Take away the wind of Jeff Jarrett.
The Beast with Jarrett in the corner is going to shove him into the ropes now. Here's Akbar again.
That's right. Young Jeff Jarrett will never
leapfrog. Look at this. Jeff Jarrett over the top, using that quickness we talked about.
Jarrett is up on the turnbuckle, waiting for the right moment. Here he comes.
Ooh, dropkick. The Beast went down hard that time for that dropkick.
Here comes Gorgeous Gary Anderson.
Oh, no, not again. Not again.
Oh, no.
Someone sets some help quick. Someone sets some help quick.
Well, big, tall, short, or small, Jeff Jarrett certainly proves he is brave inside the squared circle. In this classic battle from yesteryear, he battles manager Ronnie B. Gossett.
B. Gossett makes his way to the ring, and this time not in a management.
You're fixing to see Jeff Farrah Fawcett Jarrett get the devil beat out of him right here in front of all capacity crowd. I'm gonna take care of business, Fatso.
I thought Johnny Cash was the man in black. Looked like Ronnie P is gonna be the man in black tonight.
I had to take off my headset. That was just obnoxious.
He was spitting all over me. I felt like I was taking a shower. That was horrible.
Ronnie P. Gossett set for action.
We know what that means. Simply resistant.
Ronnie P. Gossett calling Jeff Jarrett a Farrah Fawcett lookalike. Gossett's ready for action. Or is he? Here he is, simply irresistible Jeff Jarrett, getting set to face in the ring where it quite possibly should be. Gossett.
220 pounds, Nashville, Tennessee.
And there it is, the sign of Porky.
you don't mind. Let's don't call any names. I'm not trying to take up for Mr. Johnson. Let's play off the fact that you would.
Okay. Jeff Jarrett's not going to lay off Ronnie P. Gossett.
I can tell you're not going to cooperate with me either. You're not even going to say okay.
Okay. Well, Mr. Gossett has gotten on my case, and I've only been here a few weeks.
Well, look what he's done to me. He's called me every name in the book.
The rotund one, Ronnie P. Gossett. 200, 300. Well, he'd break the scale if he got on it.
Wait a minute. No fat joke.
That's not a fat joke. That's a fact. The sounds of Porky as he dares Jeff Jarrett to cross that line.
I don't think Jeff Jarrett's going to hesitate. Does that right punch. Sends Gossett reeling right back into the rope. He's asking the crowd, do you want one more?
Now remember, poor old Ronnie P. has a heart condition that he told us about, that he's all worried about. Jeff Jarrett doesn't worry about it as he nails him with a fist to the chin. And there's the beached whale. Ronnie
Come P. on. Craig, I asked you nicely. This way off the fat joke. What if he's got, wait a minute. Here comes the dirty white boy. Tom Burton has hit the ring.
And there he goes. He's out of the ring. Ronnie P. going through the slop. I mean, going on the mat. Jeff Jarrett. There you see the fallen dirty white boys. And Jeff Jarrett calling for more of Ronnie P. And the dirty white boys making their way towards their beaten manager. But maybe they're not quite ready to leave yet. The odds are pretty good on the dirty white boys. And apparently Ronnie P. Gossett.
Jeff Jarrett standing his ground right in the middle of the ring.
Jeff Jarrett with the thumbs up as the dirty white boys make their retreat into, I guess, what you could call the pig pen.
Well, back in the early days of his career, Jarrett certainly did prove to be popular with fans of both young and young at heart. Here Jarrett battles WCW star Jeff Gaylord.
Generation wrestler. And he gets set to take on a big man, Jeff Gaylord. Jeff Jarrett says he has a dream, hopefully a destiny. A destiny, a shot at the world title. There's a big obstacle on the right of your screen. He is the Missouri Tiger, Jeff Gaylord. He held the Big 8 bench press record longer than any other man. Over 600 pounds on the bench press. He's accompanied to ringside by General Skandor Akbar, the chairman of the board of Devastation Incorporated. The battle of the Jets. And before we get the action underway, Missouri. There's the general. I don't know if you call this voguing or posing. Voguing seems to be quite in style these days.
I don't know if Jeff Jarrett appreciates
it that
much.
They want to see
something of
this.
And now opposed to the other side. We're ready for action in the two lockup. Collar and elbow into the corner. There we go. And Gaylord misses with the right. Gaylord says he pulled the hair as the general joins me.
What a physique. Is this the man, is this the specimen of Jeff Gaylord? What a superstar he's become, naturally, under my managerial genius.
Is, well, you are the general.
That's a prospect, man. Having a good move. What you see at this age?
Well, I don't want to talk about that. I just got here a few weeks ago. Let me do my job here. Here's Jeff Gaylord. He misses with a clothesline. The general Skandar Akbar, who's been buying quite a bit of talent as of late. Apparently trying to buy the announcer, too. Sorry, General, I just got here. I enjoy the position I'm in right now. By the Missouri Tiger. A little consultation between Jeff Gaylord and General Skandar Akbar. And Tony Falk with a count, hurrying Mr. Gaylord back into the ring. And now, a little trouble between Missouri and Tony Falk. Back to the ropes they go. Twice again. He misses a third time. Jeff Gaylord totally frustrating the Missouri Tiger, Jeff Gaylord. And now more consultation as the former football star goes to talk with his coach. General, no, let's call him for this. It's his coach, Skandar Akbar. Collar and elbow back into the corner they go. And Gaylord misses with a clothesline again. And Jarrett answers with a big right. Trying to hit Falk once. He tries it twice. The third time, he misses, but it's Jeff Gaylord getting the hip toss on the reversal. And now, into the corner, Jeff Gaylord flings Jeff Jarrett right into the upper arm. And now he goes back to work on that left arm, twisting and trying to punish the upper arm muscle of Jeff Jarrett. Now he wraps it around that ring table. And Tony Falk with a few words to the former football star who played for the USFL San Antonio Gunslingers. And there's some punishment as Gaylord takes a trip to the floor, holding Jarrett's arm. That can pull a shoulder out of the socket very quickly. Now he goes, boom, to the chin. Gaylord in charge here. And now back to work on the arm. Has it in a chicken.
Who's number one? Who's number one, baby?
Gaylord wanting the latest ranking, claiming he's number one by asking Jeff Jarrett who's number one. Outside flies Jeff Jarrett. While Jarrett tries to catch his breath, Gaylord tries to catch a few ladies' eyes, I do believe. They're going back and forth now. Jarrett coming back. Back and forth they go. Gaylord still maintaining the advantage. He misses with a clothesline again. He misses with a reverse clothesline. Cross body splash. There's one. There's two. And out to the ring goes Jeff Jarrett on the kick out by Jeff Gaylord. And cameraman Oz almost got an uninvited guest to the party.
Seven, eight, nine, ten.
shoulder block. Going for the sunset flip, but he missed it. No, he's going to come over with it. He gets Gaylord over. There's one. That's two. And only two before the leg of Gaylord hits the head of Jarrett. And now Jarrett rolls him up. Small package. One, two, and pure power brought Jeff Gaylord out of there. Now choking him over the top rope. And he sets him up to bring him down with the throat over the top rope. Jeff Jarrett has the arms. He's holding on for dear life. And Tony Fox puts it over. Here's the cover. One, two, three. Jeff Jarrett, who had been a victim of power moves, got a leverage move on the Missouri Tiger, Jeff Gaylord, much to the dismay of General Skandor Akbar.
Check out this matchup from the archives as Jeff Jarrett battles Billy Joe Travis.
Joe's arrival as he makes his way around the ring. There's the guitar. That baby is way, way up there. Whoever's going to get that is really going to have to scale that bowl. And what are you doing here? Jerry Lawler has come back down here.
I'm going to sit out here and do a little commentary.
Well, I didn't realize this was happening, but Jerry Lawler has returned. Billy Joe Travis has arrived in the ring where he will remove his jacket and we'll change the music and wait on the arrival of Jeff Jarrett.
Who's in this match? Jeff Jarrett.
You see, Lawler, I'm trained for you. Terrence Garvin has taught me how to respond. Billy Joe diving around in the ring against these ropes. Jeff Jarrett is on his way out of the locker room. Here he comes.
Look at those girls that he's hanging around with. Wonder how much they charge a haunted house. That's the best deal. Look at that. Look at that, right? Now, wait a minute. I guess you condone behavior like that. Is that right, Mark?
Jeff Jarrett hits the ring hot. Enough of the guitars over the head. It's time to get down to business, and that's exactly what Jarrett does.
There you go. Now, that's what the punk deserves right there. See, Jeff Jarrett, I guess he wants everything his own way. He comes out here, the match is... Oh, my God! Disqualifying! He should be disqualified right now, Mark. You know that. Look at him! Skandor Akbar, do you allow this to go on? Now he wants to use a chair on the man.
Oh, yes, a lot has been said about this Jarrett and Billy Joe's feud, you know, it's magical. I can't believe it. You know, I know Billy Joe's proved beyond a shadow of a doubt that this man is more tenacious every week that goes by. Billy Joe Travis, Lynn, King, it's nice to have you out here. You had so much class.
But I'm in shock, Skandor. I can't believe that anybody would allow this kind of behavior to go on. Is there not a referee in the ring? Does this guy not see what's taking place? Do you just let this punk Jeff Jarrett do what he wants to do? Huh? Is this a no disqualification match? Well, look at this.
The guy's on the ropes. Billy Joe is thrown and comes back with a knee that lifts Jarrett off his feet.
What can we say?
I tell you.
Of course, you're familiar with the King, I know.
I, you know, you might as well not even have a referee. Look at what's his name? What's the referee's name?
Bronco Lubitsch.
Bronco Lubitsch, look at him standing there. You know, if he was twice as smart as he is, he'd still be stupid. He don't even know where he's at. Come on, Billy. Take that punk's head off. Now, there's a good sight for you, isn't it? You know what this whole thing started over, don't you? Jeff Jarrett is so jealous of Billy Joe Travis's singing ability because Jeff Jarrett, he grew his hair long like this Bon Jovi, whatever you want to call him, this funny boy Bon Jovi. Jeff Jarrett grew his hair real long like that, and he wanted to be a rock singer, and he thought all the little girls would look up to him and admire him. And then along comes Billy Travis, who can really sing, and all the... That's right, baby. Come on, Billy. Get that guitar and play a little tune on it, Jeff Jarrett's head. Oh, look at this. Come on, Billy.
Billy Joe about to get knocked off the pole.
He should be disqualified for that.
Jarrett and Billy Joe fighting on the pole in the turnbuckle, and I hope Billy Joe does not land in our lap. Suplex off the top turnbuckle.
Oh, my gosh, where is the disqualification? Tell me.
Up to the floor they come. Head smashed into the ringside table, and I think Jarrett's ready to take on Lawler, but he wisely pays attention to Billy Joe.
I'm not going
to
ring, you idiot. Disqualified.
Look at that. Seen that.
What is this? I mean, how can you let this go on? Disqualifying.
What is this conspiracy and this officiating? I can't believe it.
Come on, Billy, hit him with a chair. Like he...
Jarrett up on the table with Travis staggering around. There's another shot from the table. And Billy Joe's weaving and falling all over the ringside area. He's already had one DDT. Now it's going to be a pile driver. Look out. Chair as well.
You've got to stand or something's got to be done. This punk's got to be disqualified. Come on, Bronco Lewis. Can you not count to 10? Disqualifying.
What an emotional bout.
Try to kill a guy and you've got to stand there watching.
Slam him. No, he's not going to slam him. It's another pile driver.
That's my patented move, that pile driver. See, that punk's trying to copy me now. He ain't going to get away with it.
Here's Jarrett climbing the pole.
Billy
Joe is out of it. Jeff Jarrett has got the guitar. Jeff Jarrett wins, ring the bell, and now he gets to use it. And Lawler is going bananas here next to me. Oh, no. Lawler is getting up in the ring. Lawler is interfering. This is terrible. Television. Oh, and Jarrett had Travis right where he wanted him. And this is a world champion. Oh, my. Billy Joe just now coming to while Lawler continues to do the dirty work. Billy Joe has now picked up the guitar, which was loose in the ring. Akbar egging more of this on. Now here's Lawler giving instructions and getting back in the ring. And Lawler is telling Billy Joe to work him over with a fist some more. Lawler has the guitar in his hand. This is getting out of hand here. Something has got to be done about this behavior of Jerry Lawler. Lawler is the one who wanted to use the guitar. Lawler has smashed a guitar now over Jeff Jarrett's head and his back. Not again. The guitar is now in shambles. Billy Joe all over him. And this is a world champion who represents all of the wrestling world. Based on his talent and his ability, here comes Kerry Von Erich now. I want to see Kerry get Lawler. Kerry having to handle both men and doing a heck of a job. Lawler really gets nailed. And tackle by Billy Joe. Jeff Jarrett and Adai's out on the floor, and Lawler grabs the strings of the guitar. Here we go again. Carey handled both men until Billy Joe tackled him. And now it's a gang up on Carey by Lawler and Billy Joe. Look at this. And here comes Jeff Jarrett with a chair. The fans want to see Lawler get his. And he escapes just in the nick of his time for saving his own hide. And Jarrett and Carey stand in the ring still wanting more. And so do these fans.
Well, many would say that Lawler stuck his mouth and his nose where it didn't belong. Is it revenge time for Jeff Jarrett? Let's go to ringside.
Jeff Jarrett making his arrival here at the Sportatorium. Ready for this exciting World Heavyweight Championship bout, which he himself earned. And as Jeff makes his arrival, let's check out his opponent, the controversial and defending unified World Heavyweight Champion, Jerry the King Lawler.
Dirty deeds and a time to cheat. Dirty deeds and a time to cheat.
And before I embarrass you in front of what few fans you have here tonight, I'll give you an opportunity to save face. I was going to say just come over here, but if you get down on your hands and knees and crawl across this ring and look up into my eyes and tell me that you are not championship material and that you are sorry that you ever even asked for a shot at my title, then I'll let you walk out and go back to that dressing room without getting your butt kicked. Do you understand? Do you want to do that?
Okay. Jarrett is had all of that he wants to hear, and he's ready to get into action as Ronnie P. Gossett now will hear something from Jerry the King Lawler. And Gossett wants the crowd quiet as Jerry Lawler still buys time against Jeff Jarrett. Jarrett at one time not too long ago had earned a world title shot against Lawler. But just as the bout was going to take place on that same night earlier in the evening, he was attacked by Jeff Gaylord and incapacitated. Question was, did Gaylord work on his own behalf or Lawler's back? Turned out to be Lawler's. But anyway, Jeff couldn't wrestle, had to forego his opportunity, had to climb the ladder again, beat Jeff Gaylord in one of a series of bouts, and earned his way back in. And Jeff Jarrett being patient, yet at
the same time, you want more of this. Okay.
The referee stands back into the rope. And Lawler is really dancing and prancing, feeling as if though he is in total control of this bout. And seeing Lawler this confident this early against the super talented Jeff Jarrett makes me think that he and Ronnie P. have got all the bases covered, and that concerns me. Showing off.
What do you mean to think about your fair-haired boy now, huh? He's nothing but a punk. He shouldn't even be in the ring with a world champion. He's still wet behind the ears.
Lawler babbling over the house speaker at every opportunity.
Let's hear you, morons. Go, Lawler, go. Go, Lawler.
Gossett, Mr. Wide Load, trying to get the fans to chant for Lawler.
Shut up! Shut
up! Jeff with a drop kick, and we'll see what Lawler has to say now as he runs over to the aid of the Wide Load. You've been wondering about him. Maybe that helps answer your question. Gossett is calling way up on the apron.
Hold it down.
If the ring can hold him.
Hold it down. Come on. Please.
What is going on here? He is standing up on the edge. Look out! I don't understand what the purpose of that was, but Lawler went thrown into the rope and bounced back and ran right under the big boy. Gossett trying to figure out exactly what he's doing anyway. A fine example of a world champion, in my opinion, which no one asked for, but I can't help but give it. And Lawler has the chain again, slipped by Ronnie P. Gossett. From behind with a chain, nails Jeff Jarrett in the head. The referee distracted by Ronnie P. Gossett. And now Jeff Jarrett is flat on his back. Lawler throws the chain back to Gossett, and everyone in the building now knows, except you know who. pulls Jeff Jarrett up. Shot to the face. Gossett with a shot of his own. And this big slob is over here choking Jeff Jarrett while the referee is distracted by Lawler. What a mess. Jarrett in bad shape as Lawler mocks the referee. Gossett is again handed the chain to Jerry the King Lawler, and there's no way Jeff Jarrett has a chance under these kinds of conditions. Right behind Lawler with a choke now. Lawler with a choke hold on Jeff Jarrett.
You quit taking a picture of this chain.
In the corner, Lawler continues. Song, fifth verse. And these crowd, these fans in this crowd getting frustrated. Hit in the turnbuckle. Look out, Gossett again reaching up and nailing Jeff Jarrett from behind. Hit in the turnbuckle. His hand in the face of Jarrett and then the shot to the midsection. Lawler with some sort of claw now in the face of Jeff Jarrett. Lawler claiming he has his own Von Erich claw, which is preposterous. Giving him a breath of new life in this bout. They each hit the other. Each man down on his back. Keep your eye on the wide load. His feet, so is Lawler. Jarrett is first to get up. There's another drive on the champion. Champion in trouble for the first time in this bout. And now it's a shot on Gossett, but Gossett throws the chain into Lawler. Jarrett getting his shots on the wide load, the damage has been done. Why would a referee turn his back on a pin like that? Now it's Jarrett with the chain, nailing Lawler. One, two. And Jeff Jarrett raises his hand. he does that, the referee sees the chain and is going to call off the win. And Lawler will retain the belt. And I know you're angry, but are you surprised? And Ronnie P. Gossett raises Lawler's hand in victory. And it's another get away with it situation for Ronnie P. Gossett and Jerry the King Lawler. Look at Lawler now implicating Jeff Jarrett. And the fans protest. Attacking Jeff Jarrett. Lawler into it with him. And this big, wide manager, who I already called a slob earlier, is out of control in the ring. And we've got an angry crowd in a bad situation. Here comes Bill Dundee. Bill Dundee down to help out. He's taking care of business best he can, but Gossett goes back in on Jarrett. Here comes Terrence Garvin. Here come the Dirty White Boys. And we've got a 5-on-2 situation all of a sudden. Anthony and Porto. And down goes Tony Falk, and it's a splash from this huge tub of lard. And I'm getting frustrated and feeling helpless. This is the last match on this card, and most of the wrestlers, if not all of them, have gone home. And this situation is just going on and on. Max Andrews, any of the wrestlers, somebody come and get this stopped. I have made a plea for help over the house mic. This slob is even hitting Tony Falk, the referee. And Jeff Jarrett is in a mess, so is Bill Dundee. And I've not seen a situation go on for this length of time with no one to help in a long time, and that's because I'm afraid there's not anybody here. They're holding Jeff Jarrett up so Lawler can do whatever he's about to do. Is there anybody left in the locker room? Someone, a promoter.